All right, guys, got my second bass of the day. I didn't get the first one on camera. This was on the Die Hard Custom Mates King Sticks. Oh, man, like right off the edge of these little lily pad things, like right there. I just had what would have been my biggest bass ever on. You know, it was like a heartbreaker. It was like about to pull me in the water. It was like enormous. I felt like I had a solid hook set on it. I fought him for about 20 seconds and then it just came up with nothing. I don't know what the deal was, but hopefully we can get some more. Alright guys, about maybe 5 minutes after that last bass, I just got this other one in. And man, this is a fighter. Nice bass, about 2 pounds. Got another one, that Die Hard Custom Baits King Sticks. Alright guys, just got this 3-pounder on that King Sticks. Man, this thing is a fighter. They fight good up in here, this little private lake. Just got another one on the King Sticks. Got another one on that King Sticks. Man, I love a dusk bite. It's, you know, sun's already kind of past the trees. Caught about 4 in the last 10 minutes. Dang, I just got another one. Missed a couple on the last cast, and I got this one. You know, if you can, there's always about 20 minutes in the morning and 20 minutes at night. And if you can find those times where you use your best baits, you're gonna really tear them up. That's like 5 in like 7 minutes, maybe. As you can see, the sun's already gone down. Barely any light out here. But yeah, I've caught all mine so far on the King Sticks.
First bass of the day on a Die Hard Custom Baits King Sticks. Wacky rig, weightless. Been here for like 2 minutes. Second bass of the morning on that King Sticks wacky rig, weightless. It's been about 20 minutes since the first one. It was a little better. See? Here's that third bass I caught on that wacky rig King Sticks again.
And I caught mine first. I was getting the hook out, and then he had his on the line, so we just got a double on his King Sticks. He's just wacky rigging them. I'm Texas rigging them.
All right, this is the fourth one I've caught on this King Sticks wacky rig. It's been about 25 seconds since, or one cast since our last video with the double.
All right, guys. The wind's blowing pretty hard, but we're still catching them. We just got another double, both using the King Sticks. Got this nice bass. I was just flipping that wild flippers like right over there. Those weeds just came up and ate it. Alright guys, got the biggest one today. The 7-inch King Sticks. For some bigger bass. To get fewer bites, but I've already had a couple of big bites. I got this one though just now. It's a nice bass.
Alright, this is our 10th bass of the day. We're fishing these like 4-inch King Sticks. Wacky style, and we just started going up here in Texas for another weightless. I don't know, no size to it, but still fun. So this is my, I guess our 11th bass of the day. Still wacky rigging these 4 inches. Got off that Texas rig 7-inch King Sticks. Die Hard Custom Baits.
All right guys, now we're going for a little bit bigger bass. All right, got this bass and the 7-inch King Sticks. It's kind of weird. He, like, I was just running over some brush. I was just like to, you know, get it through here. Like, our trolling motor can't even keep up with this wind, so we just came over here and sat in these weeds. And then, but yeah, he hit it once, and then he just, like, he missed it, and so I stopped it, and then he came back, hit it again. So, got this on the 7-inch King Sticks. This is a nice bass.
What is that, the 14th of the day? 15th, 14th? All right, now we're back to Texas rigging these 7-inch King Sticks, Die Hard Custom Baits, and I guess that's our 15th bass of the day. It's not bad, it's all right. Got some big ones up. All right, so this is the 16th bass today. Kind of small, but we're just fishing. There's like some weed pockets in here. Really actually some pretty great fishing. Just that King Sticks, 7-inch Texas rig, weightless.
Even little bitty bass weight those 7-inch King Sticks.
That's number 17?
Yeah. Alright, Luke's got one on the king sticks. It's a little one.
It's a pretty good one. It's like the 18th of the day. 19th. About a 2.5, 3 pounder. Just hope we catch about 25. Need ones this size every time.
He's got this nice little bass. Not really nice, but little bass. But, Anthony's just rigged up. Takes his rig with like a little bitty bait. 1/16 ounce screw lock weight. I missed two. One was about 3.5 pounder. Maybe. So yeah, we're going to try to get some more. Got another one at King Sticks. This one was the 4-inch one. Texas weightless. Another one on the King Sticks.
All right, so this is our 21st bass. Probably one of the better fish today, just because on an average fish kind of small. But still on that wacky rig, 5-inch.
Just switch over to that drop shot one. Just got Texas rig with a 16th ounce, a little weight, screw lock.
All right, Ian's catching one. I don't know the size of it yet. It's the first bass of the morning. Pretty good one. It's all right.
Four-inch King Six.
Texas rig?
They're kind of biting weird today. It's like the first day, they're biting it like as soon. Yeah, I've been here fishing here for 3 days. The first day, it was like as soon as I hit the water, they were just kind of like slamming. Yesterday, it was like, I'd like have to pop it like hard and they come get it, and they're hitting on the bottom. But like, and like, they're hitting it hard, but today, like, really hitting it hard. Barely feel the bite. You couldn't even really tell if it was weeds or what. Luke got one on a buzzbait.
Third bass in the morning. Pretty decent fish tonight.
It didn't really come out of the water. Like, it didn't even really look like a topwater bite. It just came out. It just came up and grabbed it. Didn't even really spike very hard.
It's not biting hard, dude.
Another bass in King Six. Alright guys, we've only been out here for about 30 minutes. We've already got a call. This one from King Sticks. This one King Sticks looks like kind of raggedy right now, you know? But they can last. This one's lasted like 5 days or whatever.
Second fish on a buzzbait. This one's a little bit smaller. Still fun to see these things surface and get this thing. Yeah, but they're not like, it's not the big explosion that you see, just a little tap.
He hit right off these little weeds right here. He threw them in there as soon as they came out, clear of them. He hammered it.
Number 3 of the day on the buzzbait. First fish on the wacky one. It just feels like a brim. They're just not hitting it good. You know? But he just kept it down.
On the King Sticks. Alright, got this one. That little drop shot one. Texas rig. Oh man, this is fun. Biting them on like a little bit of some area. Some like drops at once. It's not huge. It's fine. Chill out. Get you got it.
Grab the hook.
Oh man, that hook kicked right out. Like drop shot worms.
Pretty good fish.
I love a fight so much. That's what I love.
Double fight.
Rattan? Oh, like I caught that other one. Probably the biggest one.
Ooh, it was barely in there. It was right there. Yeah, that's a chunk right there.
Good fish.
It's a nice bass. That drop shot works. Alright guys, so we've been fishing for the last couple days. We only got to fish like for an hour today, but we caught like 10 or so, 10 or 11. We caught most of them, or like all of them on plastics. All of them that we caught on plastics were on Die Hard Custom Baits. Go check them out. I'll put the link in this description box. They're really awesome baits, as you can see. We caught a couple on a buzz bait, but other than that, it was all Die Hard Custom Baits. So yeah, go check out their website.